Dihybrid crows means we are considering two different characters. We are considering two different characters. Example, we are taking a plant, pea plant. Pea plant which having the round seeds. The pea plant which gives round shaped seed and yellow colored seed. So it is the two different characters. Other pea plant having the wrinkle shaped seed and green color seed. So here we are taking the shape of the seed and color of the seed. In monohybrid crows, we only consider one character, that is plant height. But here dihybrid crows, we are taking two characters, seed shape and seed color. Okay, that is dihybrid crows. When two individuals are crossing, having two different characters with one or more traits. Okay, so we can consider seed shape and seed color. In seed shape, which one is dominant? Round is dominant and wrinkled is recessive. And in seed color, yellow is dominant and green is recessive. Okay, so for obtaining F1, we have to cross the pure breed lines. We have to cross the pure breed lines. Okay, so round yellow cross with wrinkled green. So we are taking two plants. One plant having the seed shape round and seed color yellow. Another plant having the seed shape wrinkled and seed color green. We are crossing them. Okay, so this plant will produce gametes having, it will produce four, but now we are taking only one. Okay, so it will produce round yellow. Here it will produce wrinkled green. So these are the gametes. So what will be the F1? F1 is? F1 is heterozygous round yellow. It is same as monohybrid, but we are considering two character only. Okay, so here it is the heterozygous yellow is the F1 or first village generation. Now for obtaining F2, what we want to do? Selfing. We want to do selfing for obtaining F2. So F1 is heterozygous round yellow. So we are selfing heterozygous round yellow. So how many gametes will come from this heterozygous round yellow? How many gametes? How many possible gametes? Four possible gametes. Okay, I will give you an easy way to write or take out the gametes from the parents. First, just write R. Then small letter R, small letter R. Understand? Then just put Y. Here capital Y, here small Y. Here capital Y, here small Y. So four different gametes. Understand? Okay, here also. So we obtain four different gametes. These are gametes. So for crossing, we want to draw the we plotted the gametes on the Punnett curve. Any doubt? Now we can write what are the possible offspring or progeny which is produced. Okay, so when this gamete and this gamete grows, what will the outcome? Anyone stand and please tell me. Don't be coarse. Abhishek, tell me. You can write. Yeah. Okay. Sure. Come. So all you know how to write, isn't it? Good. So first one, the phenotype of the first offspring will be round yellow. Second offspring will be Maunish, tell me, what is the phenotype of third offspring? Praveen, what is the phenotype of the fourth offspring? Round? Split. Then what will be the phenotype of the fifth offspring? Maunish. Adhavan, what is the next phenotype? Round? Round green. Sit. Maulisharan, what is the next phenotype? Round yellow. Sit. Next, Harish. What is the next phenotype? Round green. Sit. Tarun Kumar. What is the next? Round?
Yellow.
Just look the alleles carefully. Then say. Then next, Maulish Priyan. Rupan. Next one? Correct. Nishant, next. See. Adhavan, next. Sit. Madan. Sit. Mukesh. Wrinkled tail. Sit. What is the final one? Wrinkled green. So these are the possible phenotypes which is produced by the offsprings. Okay. So how many round yellow progenies are there? Count it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. How many round yellow? 9 round yellow. How many round green? 3. How many wrinkled yellow?
3.
How many wrinkled green?
1.
Okay. So what is the dihybrid F2 phenotypic ratio? Yes, the F2 phenotypic ratio is 9:3:1. So this is the F2 dihybrid F2 phenotypic ratio. 9:3:1. What will be the genotypic ratio? So for obtaining genotypic ratio, we want to take only one homozygous round and homozygous yellow are there. So one. Then how many homozygous and heterozygous yellow? 1, 2. Just like that, you have to count. You want to know the ratio? So the ratio is 1:2, 2:1, 2:2, 4:1. So 1:2:1, 2:4:2, 1:2:1 is the dihybrid F2 genotypic ratio. Okay, so how many genotypes will be produced? Just count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 different genotypes will be produced. 9 genotypes. How many phenotypes will be produced? 4 phenotypes will be produced. So you understand what is dihybrid clone?
Yes.
Any doubt? Okay. So regarding dihybrid clones, Mendel proposed the third theory or third law, law of independent assortment. Law of independent assortment. What the law says? When two pair of character, when two pair of character are combined in a hybrid, when two pair of characters are combined in a hybrid, segregation of one pair of character is independent to the other pair of character. I will tell you. Here, there is two different characters are combined. In this F1 hybrid, two different characters are combined. What are the two different characters? Seed color and seed shape. Two different characters are combined. Okay. So, during segregation, when it will segregate? During gamete formation, the alleles will be segregated. Okay. So, during gamete formation, one character, that is round or the seed shape, and the other character seed shape are independent to each other. They are not dependent. They will go with anyone. So, the round can be go with yellow, dominant yellow, or the round can be go with recessive green. So these two characters are independent to each other while segregating. Why they are independent to each other? Why? Because in the previous class we discussed that the seven different characters are present in seven different chromosomes. The seven different characters are present in the seven different chromosomes. That's why during meiosis, actually gamete will produce during meiosis division. So during meiosis, these segregation is independent to each other. They are not dependent. That is dihybrid cross. Understand what is this law? So based on monohybrid rule, Mendel proposed law of dominance and law of segregation. Based on dihybrid rule, Mendel proposed law of independent assortment. Okay. Now we can discuss the different types of crosses. There are three types of crosses. Three types of crosses. Okay. First one, back cross. Second one, reciprocal cross. Third one, test cross. In your book, you have to study only test cross and reciprocal cross. But I will teach you what is back crosses also. Okay. The three different types of cross. First one, Test cross means we will obtain the F1. For example, we are considering tall plant. Okay, we are considering tall plant and we will obtain the F1. This is F1. Is it? This is F1. So, test cross means we are crossing the F1 with homozygous recessive parent. Homozygous recessive parent. The F1 is crossing with homozygous recessive parent. Which one is homozygous recessive parent?
Small t.
So, we are crossing the F1 with homozygous recessive parent. So, how many gametes will get? Here, 2. Here, 1. So, one heterozygous tall and one homozygous dog will be produced. So, the ratio is 1:1. So, what is test cross? Test cross is the crossing of F1 hybrid with homozygous recessive parents. We will get 1:1 ratio. Okay. So, test cross is used to find out the unknown parents. Test cross is used to find out the unknown parents. For example, if a question is given that the F1 is all tall plants. The F1 is all tall plants. Okay. And the F2. F2 will give 3 tall plants and 1 dwarf plant. The question is here. So, what will be their parents? The question may be, what will be their parents? So, here, what is the question? F1 is all tall. F1 is tall and F2 is 3 tall and 1 dot. 3 tall and 1 dot. Okay. So, from this, the F1 may be capital T, capital T or capital T, small t. Maybe homozygous tall or heterozygous tall. But, while looking the F2, F2 is 3 tall and 1 dot. So, there is a presence of 1 dwarf character. So, the F1 must containing at least 1 dwarf allele. So, we can simply eliminate homozygous dwarf and only heterozygous. Okay. So, the F1 is heterozygous dwarf. So, to find out the parents, we want to test cross it. So, test cross means from this also we are sure that one parent will at least contain 1 dwarf character. So, parent may be capital T or capital T, small t, maybe. So, we want to test cross it. Okay. So, by test crossing, we can obtain. So, test crossing means we will taking dwarf plant, homozygous recessive dwarf plant. So, while test crossing, it is sure that one will be homozygous recessive. The other may be homozygous tall or heterozygous tall. So, for obtaining the F1 all tall plants, it should be homozygous tall. Okay, some rare questions may be asked like this. So, for test cross is for finding the unknown parents, for finding the unknown genotype of the parents. So that is test cross. Test cross is the crossing of F1 with homozygous recessive parents. Second one, back cross. What is back cross? Back cross means crossing of F1 with any one of the parents. No need of whether it is a homozygous recessive parent or homozygous dominant parent. Any one of the parents. It is to improve the breeding. Back cross we are tending to improve the breeding. Test cross is for to find out the unknown parents. Unknown genotype of the parents. Okay. Then back cross is F1 is crossing with any one of the parents. any one of the parents. Then finally, reciprocal growth. What is reciprocal growth? Reciprocal growth means, for example, we are taking round seed and wrinkle seed. Round and wrinkle seed bearing plants. In first growth, the round is male and the wrinkled is female. In the first growth, the round is male and the wrinkled is female. We get heterozygous round. Heterozygous round. In the next growth, we are reciprocally or we are interchanging the parentship. That is, in the next growth, we will take round as female and wrinkled as male. Only we are changing the parentship. Okay, understand. This is reciprocal growth. So, three types of growth. First one, test growth. Second one, back growth. And third one, reciprocal growth. So, test growth is to find out the genotype of unknown parents. So, test growth means F1 hybrid is crossed with the homozygous recessive parent. Second one, back growth. Back growth means the F1 hybrid is crossed with any one of the parents. Third one, reciprocal growth means we are changing the parentship on adjacent crosses. Understand? In your book, you have to study dihybrid test growth. Dihybrid test growth. So dihybrid means we want to take two different characters. We want to take two different characters. Look. Look, parents, homozygous round yellow and homozygous wrinkle green. So, from parents, we obtain gametes. That is, here round yellow, here wrinkle green. So, the F1 is heterozygous round yellow. So, what is test growth? Nishant, what is test growth? Yes, sit down. So the F1 hybrid is crossing with the homozygous recessive parent. Homozygous recessive parent. Here the homozygous recessive parent is double recessive. Why? Because there is two characters. So we will say double recessive. So the homozygous double recessive parent. We want to cross the F1 hybrid with homozygous double recessive parent. Okay. So, this is the F1. We are crossing with homozygous double recessive. Here, how many gametes we will obtain? How many gametes we will obtain, Abhishek? Yes, 4. 4 gametes will be obtained. Here, how many gametes will obtain?
4
gametes will be obtained. 4 gametes will be obtained. Okay. So, can I rub this? Rub this? You understand? Now, we can put the Punnett square. So, while after putting Punnett square, we can find out what are the genotypes or what are the phenotypes. Okay. So, here, all the gametes are same. Here, all the gametes are same. So, we are only taking only one gamete at a time. So, we can put here. Then, capital R, capital Y, small y. Okay. So, here it will be, is it? Here it will be, so how many capital R, small r, capital Y, small y? 1. Here also 1, here also 1, here also 1. So what is the ratio? 1 is to 1 is to 1 is to 1. The genotype ratio is also 1 is to 1 is to 1. Phenotype also 1 is to 1. This is round yellow, this is round green, this is wrinkled yellow, this is wrinkled green. So you understand what is dihybrid test cross? Okay. So this is about dihybrid test cross. Okay. So these are about today's portions. We completed monohybrid cross, dihybrid cross, the laws regarding monohybrid cross, laws regarding dihybrid cross, and what are back cross, test cross, and reciprocal cross. Okay. So monohybrid cross means we are taking or inheritance of only one character at a time. The monohybrid F2 phenotypic ratio is 3 is to 1. The monohybrid F2 genotypic ratio is 1 is to 2 is to 1. And law of dominance and law of segregation of gametes are the two laws which is proposed based on the monohybrid cross. Then dihybrid cross means inheritance of two different characters at a time. Inheritance of two different characters at a time. The dihybrid F2 phenotypic ratio is 9 is to 3 is to 3 is to 1, and the F2 genotypic ratio is that huge ratio, 1 is to 2 is to 1 is to 2 is to 4 is to 2 is to 1 is to 2 is to 1. So 9 different types of genotypes and 4 different types of phenotypes are produced as a result of dihybrid cross. And regarding dihybrid cross, law of independent assortment are proposed by Mendel. Then three different types of cross, that is test cross, back cross, and reciprocal cross. Test cross means F1 hybrid is crossed with homozygous recessive parent. Second one, back cross means the F1 hybrid is crossed with any one of the parent. Then reciprocal cross means we are changing the parentship in adjacent crosses. You understand? Okay. Then finally, dihybrid test cross. We are considering the F1 having two characters and we are crossing with the homozygous double recessive parent. Homozygous double recessive parent. Okay. So the ratio will be 1 is to 1 is to 1 is to 1. So we can go with a quick recap. Take your note. First question. Crossing of F1 hybrid with homozygous recessive parent. Crossing of F1 hybrid with homozygous recessive parent. Second question. Number of characters inherited during dihybrid cross. How many number of characters inherited during dihybrid cross? Third question, how many gametes formed? How many gametes will form from a genotype heterozygous round yellow? Heterozygous round yellow. How many gametes formed from heterozygous round yellow? Then fourth one, ratio of dihybrid test cross. Ratio of dihybrid test cross. Last question. Law of independent assortment. Law of independent assortment is proposed based on which type of cross? Law of independent assortment is proposed based on which type of cross? Answers. First one, test cross. Second answer, number of characters inherited during dihybrid cross, 2. Third one, how many gametes formed from heterozygous round yellow, 4. Ratio of dihybrid cross is 1 is to 1 is to 1 is to 1. Then finally, law of independent assortment is proposed based on which type of cross? Dihybrid cross. So these are about today's class. Tomorrow we can discuss about the gene interaction. There are two types of gene interaction, intragenic interactions and intergenic interactions. These are some extensions. The intragenic interactions and intergenic interactions are from the extension of Mendelism. Okay, we will discuss those things on our next class. Thank you.